Have you ever heard about a planet in our solar system called Vulcan? It was an extremely hot reddish planet closer to the Sun than Mercury, which was observed many times by different astronomers throughout decades. However, it turns out that Vulcan never actually existed. And what's even more interesting is that Newton's laws of motion and gravity are to blame. You see, before Newton, astronomers could only discover planets by observing them with the naked eye or using telescopes. But Newton's laws enabled them to find new space objects based solely on mathematical formulas. In other words, astronomers were able to discover planets using theory alone, without directly observing them. This made things much easier, since all astronomers had to do was observe instances in space where Newton's laws were being violated. These cases would indicate influence from an unknown cosmic object, meaning the presence of something yet to be discovered. Then, their exact location could be calculated using formulas. Think about it this way. Newton's laws were used to predict the orbits of planets. And when the telescope observations indicated a deviation from the predicted orbit, scientists were certain that it was caused by another object's gravity. They would then start calculating where that unknown force was located. This is exactly how Neptune, the eighth planet in our solar system, was discovered. You see, when Uranus was found in 1781, scientists started applying Newton's formulas to predict its orbit. However, the results didn't match what they were seeing with their telescopes. There were two possibilities. Either Newton's laws functioned differently at such distances, which hardly anyone believed back then, or there was another, very large object affecting the orbit of Uranus. Many scientists started trying to identify that mysterious object, but it was a French astronomer, Urbaine Le Verrier, who predicted not only the existence of Neptune, but also its precise location. In 1846, he mailed a letter to Johann Galle, a scientist at the Berlin Observatory, describing his predictions about the eighth planet. Galle pointed the telescope at the specified location and confirmed the discovery of a new planet, exactly where Le Verrier had predicted. Le Verrier had just discovered a new planet solely based on theory, astonishing the scientific community. He gained a strong reputation, which is why his next discovery was taken very seriously and garnered immense attention. In 1859, he observed a similar discrepancy in Mercury's orbit. Again, what he saw in the telescope wasn't matching the mathematical predictions. Mercury's closest point to the Sun was shifting more than predicted by 43 arcseconds per century, which is nearly 1/10,000th of a degree. It was clear that something was interfering with Mercury's orbit. Le Verrier suggested that there was a planet invisible to us between Mercury and the Sun that was affecting its orbit. He also said that the only way to observe the unknown planet is either during a total solar eclipse or when it is perfectly aligned between the Sun and Earth. Considering Le Verrier's success with Neptune, the whole scientific community was trying to observe the new planet through their telescopes. On December 22, 1859, another French astronomer, Edmond Lescarbault, claimed that he had seen an unfamiliar planet transiting the Sun, a scene that Le Verrier had described. Le Verrier first took a train, then walked for 12 miles to Lescarbault's house. He arrived without warning and started asking him questions. Lescarbault explained that he first saw a black spot on the Sun's surface, which he later noticed was moving. The transit reminded him of watching Mercury cross the Sun. Using basic tools like a small telescope and an old clock, he calculated that the transit lasted 1 hour, 17 minutes, and 9 seconds. Le Verrier was at first skeptical because of the equipment Lescarbault used, but was convinced by his findings regardless. In 1860, Le Verrier officially announced the discovery of the ninth planet, naming it Vulcan, after the Greek god of fire, which made sense given its proximity to the Sun. So here it was, a newly discovered intermercurial planet. Its existence made perfect sense at the time, yet it was pure fiction. For a world that never even existed, it had a remarkably detailed description. Vulcan was thought to be a reddish planet with a hot, rocky surface. Located just 13 million miles from the Sun, it was more than twice as close as Mercury. Therefore, it completed a full orbit around the Sun in just about 19 days, meaning you would celebrate the new year every 19 days if you lived on Vulcan. Although some astronomers showed skepticism, the scientific community believed in Vulcan for decades after its discovery. Many scientists claimed they had observed Vulcan through their telescopes during a solar eclipse. However, there were no legitimate documents of the observations, and the only convincing evidence of Vulcan's existence was the fact that math didn't add up otherwise. This changed when one of the most crucial discoveries in physics was announced, which would redefine the way we think. In 1915, Albert Einstein erased the planet Vulcan forever. It turns out that the problem with Mercury's orbit wasn't due to a hidden planet, but because of the limitations of Newton's laws. After he established the general relativity theory, it easily explained the peculiarity in Mercury's orbit. The discrepancy was caused by the Sun's curvature of space-time. The theory accounted for the 43 arcseconds per century shift of Mercury's closest point to the Sun. Einstein's discovery didn't replace Newton's laws, but rather extended and made them more precise. The general relativity theory predicts different planetary orbits in our solar system. However, the differences between Einstein's theory and Newton's laws significantly diminished as you moved further away from the Sun, which explains why Le Verrier was so precise in predicting Neptune's location. Following this discovery, the scientific community was quick to accept that no planet between Mercury and the Sun had ever existed. Astronomers had not seen an actual planet through telescopes, but had either misinterpreted their observations or mistaken a sunspot for a planet. In my opinion, there was a lot of wishful thinking involved in the story of Vulcan. Scientists were so focused on finding the new planet that they essentially invented it out of nothing. We shouldn't forget that science is driven by humans, and humans have their flaws. It makes me wonder how many other things about the universe we are getting wrong.